Kevin Cashin here with the ABS YouTube channel, and I'm here at the Miami County Fairgrounds in Troy, Ohio at the SOFA facility, that's the Southern Ohio Forge and Anvil, for the 14th annual ABS Mid-America Hammer-In and Blade Exhibition. Yeah, 14 years of one of the best hammer-ins that we have. It's just fantastic, and particularly because of the SOFA facility, the Southern Ohio Forge and Anvil, because not only is the facility's just top-notch for doing a hammer-in, but the people are the friendliest and most accommodating. I really enjoy any time I get to spend with the people here at SOFA, and particularly at this hammer-in, which has now become one of our most successful hammer-ins. I believe at last count we have well over 80 registrants, and we haven't even started yet. There will be more people coming in, and that's what I'd like to take some time to show you now, are some of the fantastic learning opportunities that you can have at an ABS hammer-in. So why don't we go talk to some of the people? And now we're talking to ABS Master Smith, Jim Rodabaugh, and we were very lucky to have him as a guest here this weekend at the Mid-America. What was it that you demonstrated and shared with us?
Well, I demonstrated forging a knife blade from start to finish, and a little bit of heat treating, which Kevin took over later. Then I demonstrated grinding and went into different grinds, how to achieve them, two different grinding methods. And that's about it for the hammer-in. So.
And I'm sure it went over really well. Probably had a really, really good crowd.
I think so. Yep. We had probably 40 or 50 people in the bleachers for both those demonstrations.
Yeah. And what people need to realize about that, at the ABS Mid-America, there will be several lectures, talks, or demos to choose from at that time. And so that is a very good turnout when it's split among maybe two or three other.
Yeah, I think this is without a doubt the most bang for your buck. If you're a beginning knife maker, if you're getting into knife making, and you're going to get good straight information, not voodoo. All of the demonstrators here are tried and tested. They're giving out good solid information that we've acquired over years and years of practice. So I think it's probably the best way to go for a guy that maybe wants to dip his foot in the water and isn't quite ready to take the full plunge.
Yeah, and I would definitely agree with that. And we can't thank you enough for helping us out in that effort.
Thanks, Kevin. Yep. I appreciate it.
Thank you. And here we are with one of our featured demonstrators, somebody that you'll probably recognize his name quite well. And we're really happy to have with us Jerry Rados. And Jerry, what did you demonstrate this weekend for us?
I demonstrated how to assemble and prepare and assemble Turkish Damascus billets.
Turkish Damascus billets, and everything came off without a hitch, I'm assuming. I'm pretty sure it would with you.
Other than the fact that we couldn't get the forges up to heat.
If it can go wrong at a demo, it will.
Exactly. But we did fumble our way through it, and we got the point across.
Okay, excellent. Well, we're very, very happy that you came and visited us, and we're glad to have you. So thank you very much. Talking with my good friend Bill Wiggins, and Bill, what was it that you showed or talked to us about this weekend at the?
Started with talk on setting up a shop, different tooling, and what you might need to start knife making, the stuff you'd need for grinding knives for your hot shop, and things like that. And then I helped Jim Rodabaugh do a class on judging standards, where we talked about the different criteria that had to be met before you could test, and then what the judges would be looking for when you done the actual test. And then I think this evening we're doing a cutting demonstration.
Now, how important do you think it is in the success of somebody going for a journeyman or mastersmith stamp of the ABS to attend a talk like that?
I think it's very important. In fact, I talked to a gentleman in the class who was not successful in testing for journeyman last year, and he was in the class and said he really picked up a lot of good information. So it'll give the applicants, they'll know what the judges are looking for, and you just set yourself up for success by doing that. I think it's a critical step.
Okay, so yeah, that's just one more invaluable asset that an ABS hammer-in can give to somebody who, whether they want to go for the stamps or not, the information is phenomenal that you get at these hammer-ins. But if you're going to be testing for those stamps, can you think of any other opportunity that is as golden as actually having somebody like you and Jim or other mastersmiths that have judged?
Well, you have a chance to possibly, depending on which hammer-in you're at, talk to some of the judges. I know you and Jim and myself have all judged in the past, and it's just a lot easier to point out things we see that maybe if they hadn't have met people, they wouldn't have known that we would be looking for. So it's like Kevin says, it's invaluable, and we're here to help. We want to see folks pass and do good. That's we're in the business of doing that. So,
and we greatly appreciate your help in us of being able to do that in the ABS. So thank you. Green Coal Demo with our helpful guy that's been doing this for some time, and we really appreciate him, Shane Most.
Thank you, Kevin.
How many people have you had come through the Green Coal today?
Today we only had one come through today. Throughout the weekend we've had maybe 7 or 8 people come through. We've had novices, never forged a knife before, and we've had people who have forged a knife and just wanted to try an idea of something they learned during other presentations and just wanted to experiment and moved on past that. So here in the Green Coal Forge, we just offer a hot fire that is out of the way for someone to experiment or to hopefully try and build a knife blank ready for grinding.
Great. And how many years you've been doing this for us? We appreciate it, but I know you've been really, really, really a valuable asset to us.
I've been in part of the ABS for 10 years, and I've probably been working, helping in the Green Coal for 5 or maybe 7 years.
Okay. And that's something to remember. It's an asset at these hammer-ins. One of our favorite things, if you've never forged a blade before and you want to get started in this, you can come in just off the street, sign up for the hammer-in, and we can get you started in forging, and you can take whatever your career wants to go from there. So thank you very much, Shane.
Thank you.
Talking with Tom Golkert.
Yes.
He was very, very generous with his time this weekend here with at the ABS Mid-America. And what was it that you talked to us about and helped us understand?
We had a terrific question and answer session. Kind of went over abrasives 101, as I call it. So many guys in this industry say, hey, you know, you got belts pricing down here, belts all the way up to there, and you know, I'm sure the better ones are going to last longer, but are there certain times I should use these things? So we had really nice discussions back and forth. There's a lot of products that the guys don't know are even available. Scalloped edge belts, guys that are working on handles tend to gouge them. So those are available now. We talked about the different backings, and some are terrible. Some guys like to tear their belts into narrower strips, and some of the backings don't permit that. They're too strong, too tough. So I was about as pleased as could be. We just had a great couple-hour session.
Okay, it's something that I haven't seen too often that I think is needed in the industry, and we thank you very much for doing that, and
sure.
Thank you for coming.
Well, I was very pleased to be asked to do it, so thank you to everyone involved.
Heat to full solution, repeat as necessary.
But what that does is it doesn't mess with grain size, it doesn't mess with carbide size. All it does is it takes these defects in the atomic lattice and snaps them back into alignment and straightens everything out. It's a process known as recovery, and it has to do with the way that deformation occurred inside of the steel. But the magic of this is it all started to click and make sense when I started putting this process together as well. You see how each heat got cooler as you went. You started out with normalizing, which is up in your forging is the absolute hottest. Then forging gets a little cooler towards the end. Then you come back with normalizing, which is way up there at 1650, maybe 1700. And then you follow that up with these other cycles that get lower, down to 1500, 1475. And then you finally follow that up with the subcritical anneal, around 1300 degrees. And then the final one after that would be stress relieving, which is at 1200 degrees. And like I said, it's just like these complex solder jobs. You use the high temperature solder and you work down the lower temperature solder, so you don't undo what you've just done.